So what is pain? Well, pain has been defined a number of different ways. One definition that we use commonly in our field is from the International Association for the Study of Pain, which has defined pain as an unpleasant sensory and emotional experience associated with actual or potential tissue damage, or described in terms of such damage. Now that's quite a mouthful. So let's break it down to its key components. It's an unpleasant sensory and emotional experience. In defining it that way, it's saying that pain is incredibly personal. It's subjective. It's unique to that individual. Inherent within that is a recognition that everybody experiences pain differently for the same stimulus or the same injury. Now, I teach the pain courses at Stanford for the medical students, and we often have them stick their arm in a bucket of circulating ice water, and we have them pull it out after 15 seconds and give us the pain score, and we show them at the end of the class what their pain ratings are. And what we find here is this incredible range from people saying, nope, I had a 0 out of 10, where 0 is no pain and 10 is the worst imaginable. And we had people all across the spectrum, all the way up to 8 to 10 out of 10 saying, oh my God, that's the most painful thing ever, all to the same stimulus. And that drives this point home about that individual aspect of pain. Now, I'll share with you what's missing, in my opinion, from that definition is the fact that pain is the great motivator. And we're missing that definition aspect of motivation. It is probably one of the largest motivators that goes all the way back to single-cell organisms, pain and reward. And it is, in essence, what helps keep us alive, because pain serves a physiologic basis of keeping us out of trouble. It keeps us away from harm. And in fact, what makes pain so wonderful is because it is so incredibly terrible. You know, we only have to touch a hot stove once to learn not to do it again, because it's there to keep us out of harm's way, to keep us out of danger. It's when pain becomes chronic that things go awry, when it's no longer serving that survival basis that we run into challenges. And that's where chronic pain comes in, which is this pain that has this incredible toll on the individual as well as their families and society as a whole. So we don't want to take away acute pain in its entirety. It's there to serve a real benefit for us. But we do, in this day and age, want to find ways of better controlling, for instance, acute pain, so that people can better rehabilitate after an injury or after a surgery. And then we also need to find better ways of controlling chronic pain, which again serves no basis, no benefit for us at all.
The preceding program is copyrighted by the Board of Trustees of the Leland Stanford Junior University. Please visit us at med.stanford.edu.